Hey, what is up, fellow raiders? This is Vulcan Dan, and in today's beginner-friendly Raid Shadow Legends video, I just want to talk about some common mistakes that new players tend to make when deciding on which stats to prioritize when building out their champions. Alright, so first thing that I want to talk about is accuracy. Now, some new players tend to think that accuracy affects hit rate, which is it affects whether your attacks will hit or miss your opponent, but in raid that is not the case. Accuracy only affects the rate to which your debuffs land on your opponents. Now let's take a look at one popular champion, Tayrell. His A1, A2, and A3 all have debuffs, decrease attack, decrease defense, and sleep, and stun. So this is one example of a champion that will definitely need accuracy in order for these skills to land on your opponent. Now, let's take a look at another popular champion, Apothecary. Now, this guy is a good example of a champion that does not need any accuracy at all. Zero accuracy. Any accuracy that you put on this guy will technically be wasted because his A1, A2, and A3, all of his skills do not place any debuffs on the opponent. Therefore, he does not require any accuracy. Buffs like this one, increased speed, does not need any accuracy for them to be placed on your teammates. Right? So just remember that. No accuracy on champions like this one. Another good example, of course, is one of our starter champions, Elhane. As you can see, A1, A2, and A3, no debuffs. So you can just focus on getting her HP, attack, defense, speed, and don't really worry about accuracy when building out this champion. All right, so that's number one. Number two that I want to talk about is there are some champions that while they do not place any debuffs on your opponent, they still need accuracy, and that is the case with this guy right here, one of the most popular uncommon champions in the game, Armiger. All right, so he has this decreased turn meter on his A1. This does not technically show up as a debuff, but this requires accuracy for it to land. So this is one of the few exceptions. It's not a debuff, but technically decreased turn meter does require accuracy for it to land. And of course, for this guy, you also need to make that attack critical. So make sure you build his crit rate up to 100% or as close to 100% as possible. All right, next thing that I want to talk about is not all champions that require crit rate would require a lot of crit damage. Now, of course, it makes sense. If you're building a champion with 100% crit rate, you would, of course, or you might want to build them out with as much crit damage as possible to take advantage of crit rate. But that is not the case with some of these champions. Let's go back to Apothecary. So this guy on his A2 has a big heal, 35% HP, and this heal can be critical, but technically Apothecary is not a damage dealer. So while you may be tempted, of course, to build him out with really high crit damage, you shouldn't do that, in my opinion. You can put those stats in HP, defense, speed, because you don't really rely on Apothecary for crit damage or any damage whatsoever. He just has this A1 that is his only attack skill, because his A2 and A3 does not hit the enemy. So yeah, so you don't really need to build him with a lot of crit damage, but yes, do get his crit rate as close to 100% as possible. Now I just want to take a look at another champion to show this example, Vrask from the orcs. Now this guy, for his passive, he will heal all allies by 10% of his max HP whenever he inflicts a critical hit. But this guy is more of a healer. All right, so his A1 fills this champion's turn meter by 20% if this attack is critical. So yeah, so his A1, of course, you want this to crit. His passive also benefits from crit. So you have to build him with 100% crit rate, but he does not hit hard. So you don't really need to build him with crit damage, but instead, if you're building out Vrask, just pump his HP as high as possible, because of course you really want this heal to be as big as possible. So if you have 100,000 HP on Vrask, that is 10,000 HP each time he he crits with his attack. Right, so that is another thing that is number three. You don't really need to build crit damage on certain champions just because you build them out with 100% crit rate. Alright, so that's number three. Number four is you don't really need to build certain champions with 100% crit rate because some of their skills, maybe one, two, or all three of their skills have some additional crit rate built on top of them. So let's take a look at another popular champion, Coldheart. Yes, a Void Rare. Her A3, Heartseeker, gives you an extra 30% crit rate, so you actually only need to build her with 70% crit rate. Now, some players still build her with 100% crit rate because her A1 and A2 does not have that extra 30% crit rate that her A3 gives, but you don't really need her to crit on her A1 and A2 because you just really care about this A3, this hard-hitting A3. So yes, you can just build her with 70% crit rate, and it is fine if you just have 70% crit rate for her A1 and A2 because you just really need her A3 to hit hard. So yeah, so you can focus on, instead of building her with 100% crit rate, you can focus on HP, speed, crit damage. So yes, you don't have to worry about getting that crit rate all the way up to 100%. All right, and lastly, number five, your starter champions, whether it's Kayle, Elhane, Galek, or Aethel. So let's take a look at Kayle. You also do not need to build them with 100% crit rate because Kayle's A2 right here, which is his huge nuke, has an extra 15% chance of inflicting a critical hit. So all of your starter champions will have this built in their kit. Now, same with Coldheart, it does not apply to every single one of their skills. But in this case, you don't really need for every single one of their skills to hit, to be a critical hit every single time. You just need to make sure that their big hit is the one that crits all of the time. So their A1, their A2 will technically only have 85% crit rate if you build them up to 85%, but this is the one that matters. So this one will have 100% with that extra 15% chance to crit. All right, that is it. So I hope you found this useful. And if you want more beginner friendly or free to play friendly guides, do not forget to subscribe to this channel. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video.